And here right now with us is one of the mothers who was at the protest this morning at Cathedral Catholic High School.
That's right. You just saw her in the story. This is Michelle Adams. You have two daughters that go to school there. So has this been an ongoing issue that you've been hearing about all school year until just now?
No, the very first time I heard about this was on Friday when I received the email from Principal Calkins.
Mm-hmm. So you have two daughters Yes. that have been going there. They leave the house and they wear their skirts and they look perfectly fine.
Yes.
The principal says part of the problem is that they've issued thousands of hours of detention to girls who maybe when they leave the house afterwards, they hike up the skirts and they're inappropriately short. And so that's the reason for the ban.
Yeah, and we're a little bit unclear about that statement that he made because actually this year they've not been enforcing the policy at all. There's been no detentions given. And I think that's actually led to part of this problem. They decided to do away with the plaid skirts and move to a buy any skirt that you want. And then also moved away from detentions and just were going to do a sort of a touchy-feely approach to discipline. And supposedly we were going to be called in to meet with them when there were dress code violations to meet with the student and the administration. But as far as I know, there have been no dress code violations or meetings of such so that we would even know that there is a problem or an issue.
Mm-hmm. So you say a touchy-feely approach. What do you mean by that?
Well, instead of doing discipline like detentions, I mean, you might remember when you were in high school, you'd have to go sit on a Saturday with 4-hour detention. They don't want to take that type of discipline. They want to have meetings where instead you are called in to meet with the dean of students and have your parent with you, and then we discuss the issue at hand.
Mm-hmm. So what would you like to see happen? They're recommending that girls from starting next year can wear Bermuda shorts, they can wear capris, or they can wear pants. Anna and I were talking and thought, maybe, what about a skirt with shorts underneath? What's wrong with that?
And I actually suggested that to Principal Calkins. I actually wrote him a detailed email expressing my concern and frustration over the fact that the parents weren't involved and notified of this or allowed to have any sort of collaboration. I think there's a lot of solutions, easy solutions. I suggested skorts. Girls can wear spandex under their skirts. Then what's the issue? Have a policy where if you get 3 violations, you have to wear pants for the rest of the school year. I just don't understand why if there's, you know, why do you have to punish the whole when it's just a few that are violating the rule? Mm-hmm. You know, this mentality of collective punishment just doesn't seem to be the right answer.
Now, I was reading some of the comments online, and mostly people are supporting parents and the students there. But some, I did see some comments, and they're like, what's the big deal? I would think that parents of teenage girls would be happy that they would have to wear pants and not skirts to school.
I think the problem is that the what they're being asked to wear are what the boys wear. And so they're being basically told that they can't identify with their gender, that they need to look and dress like the boys. And I don't understand why women are constantly being told that we need to be more like men. We're not. We're different. We're women. We have different bodies and pants and shorts. I mean, how many teenage girls do you see walking around in Bermuda shorts? That's just not something that they're comfortable in. And I think it's going to disrupt their learning environment.
Well, Cathedral Catholic High School administrators have 3 months to figure this out before mm-hmm, September when everybody comes back, and hopefully there will be some kind of a compromise or solution to it all.
Maybe some skorts in the future.
Yeah.
Thanks so much for joining us.
Michelle
Thank
Adams,
you.
Thank you.
Appreciate
it.